Besides that, best-selling author and founder of Social Media Safety for Kids, Tracy Repchuk, has been working with technology since she was a teen.
And now with her own three teenagers on social media, she realized how big the technology gap is between parents and the danger zone. And Tracy is joining us this morning right here on New Mexico Style with some information. Hi, Tracy.
Morning. Thanks for being here. Appreciate it.
All right. Well, it's Labor Day weekend, and we got to keep our kids safe.
Absolutely. Yes, how important is it for parents not just to watch over their kids and what they're doing, but to watch out what they're doing online and with social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all that stuff?
It's very important. I mean, iPads, iPhones, their laptops. Kids are on these devices 5 to 8 hours every single day. Mm-hmm. 43% of them have reported an incident of cyberbullying and cyberstalking. Over 1 million have reported an incident on Facebook alone, and only 7% of parents are aware or concerned, and that's because they just don't know. The technology gap is widening.
Right, it sure is. And then you've created this safe formula that's supposed to help parents kind of get through us and help out, watch out for the kids. Can you tell us about it?
Yes. Well, I created it so it's nice and simple to remember. So S, for example, stands for secure your data. Mm-hmm. Now, a lot of times your data can be wide open, your address, all sorts of information, private information is going out about you and mm-hmm. your kids, in fact. So it's very important that you get up in there and make sure the settings are set to private or only friends in the case of Facebook. You know, don't make sure that it's wide open for your problems.
Okay, we go through the rest of it.
Yes.
The A, the F, and the E.
Yes, okay, so A is ask questions. Mm. Now, you know, our kids come home from school and we say, hey, how was your day? But what we're not asking is what's going on in your social media. This is where they're spending mm-hmm. their time. So, for example, you're going to have to be a friend to your child. You're going to have to scan their account just mm-hmm. really quickly. I spend 2 minutes a day just quickly going down. And if you see something that alarms you, something that doesn't look quite right, you know, hey, do you know this person? What's happening? And mm-hmm. if you don't know this person, get them off your account immediately.
Okay, great.
What about the F and the E?
So the F, fans aren't always friends. Really important. Don't accept anybody that you don't know. You know, right now things are going on where a 44-year-old man is posing as a 16-year-old girl, and even worse, if you're making plans to meet offline, this is where tragedy is occurring. I mean, it's one thing, you know, to get your feelings hurt and things like that on here. It's another to meet somebody and have something really severe happen.
Right.
And then the E, educate them on the issues. Again, we teach our kids how to cross the street, stranger danger, you know, drop and roll in a fire. Mm-hmm. What we're not doing is talking about the issues of social media, which are cyberstalking. What is that? They may not even know. Cyberstalking, cyberbullying, you know, it might seem normal to them, but it's mm-hmm. not. And then most of all, you have to educate them on what they're posting, and the pictures that they're putting up there are going to affect them forever and ever.
Right.
You know, this could be job issues in the future, relationship issues in the future, college applications. You know, this stuff is in there in perpetuity, and so it's important that they know that.
Yeah, this is very, very, very good advice that you're giving there. And of course, you have it in your book, and we can find more information there.
Exactly. Well, it's a free download for the viewers, and so they can go and get themselves a free copy.
Great.
Okay. The other thing, here's parents talk about this a lot. What age should kids be allowed to get their own social media accounts, whether it's Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram, or if anybody still uses MySpace?
Okay, so the legal age, LinkedIn has actually just reduced it to 14. Mm-hmm. Definitely, you know, kids are getting it at 14, mm-hmm. Facebook and all of those, and Twitter. However, the reality is, kids are up there at the age of 8. Between the cell phones, having the cell phone access, as soon as you have that, they're opening up an account. They're not just texting, they're tweeting, they're Facebooking, mm-hmm. they're very, very tech savvy, and most adults aren't.
So we need to make sure that we're savvy too in all the social media aspects. So that, or it's parents, I'm not a parent
one day.
But we need to make sure we're savvy on all that, and so that way we can keep it better eye on our kids and what they're doing too.
That's it. You know, it's keeping them safe.
Exactly.
Okay. You can get information about Tracy's book and the free download by heading to our website, KASA.com. Tracy Repchuk, thank you so much for coming in. There's the information right there. You can also hit up her website, socialmediasafetyforkids.com.